far, but what does it say about Rover's long-term future?
I've just driven an Alfa Romeo, which manages to feel Italian, but without being too temperamental, and a BMW, which somehow feels German, but isn't too pompous. So why do our cars have to be twee? The Rover 75 seems to confirm something that I've long feared, that Britain is being turned into a fatuous theme park, obsessed with heritage and cowering behind a barricade of stupid nostalgic knick-knacks. This is Rover! Rover! The company that gave us great cars like the P6, the SD1 and that experimental turbine car. I want something modern, not a great day out in history. This ridiculous hankering for the past is just not British. I can't stand it!
Still, don't let me put you off. Here's the lineup, and you can make your own mind up in June when the car goes on sale. Oh, and when you visit the dealer, remember to wear your tweed hat.
Or your